Everybody, it's Victa's continuing streak here in the Binding of Isaac Victa Afterbirth Plus series. Oh my goodness, the mosh pit coming out in almost record numbers to rally over 12,000 likes on the No Seas Challenge run, which I've given you credit for. And on top of that, not only did you hit 12,000 likes on the No Seas Challenge run, you also hit 4,000 likes on the Alternate Universe run, and you also hit 4,000 likes on today's run. Well, technically yesterday's run. Today for me, yesterday for you all, with the Sinus Power run and going strong. Holy moly. Thank you all very much for that. Sincerely, it is a huge, huge part of how we stay awesome in the mosh pit. Thank you very much. Here's your meme of the day brought to you. This is a little bit of a joint meme of the day because I did see something similar to this one, but this one was submitted by Sean Bones, titled My First Memes. Invictus playing some Isaac. Aww. So Victor playing in the studio. Well, not really playing. I mean, I do play in the studio, but I also sing in the studio. Rah! Yeah, so the it's a co-meme of the day because shout out I believe it was Dodo Sandwich who made something very similar a couple months ago, but I didn't actually pick it. But I picked it this time. So thank you both, and let's hop on in to this here run. Today is going to be X-Ray Sierra, X-Ray 6, Whiskey 4, 3 Lima. We've got amazing starting stats here thanks to the Pact along with Lost Fly and the Blue Hourglass, also known as the Glowing Hourglass. Now, everyone, and hang on a second here. Why are you starting with two items there, buddy? What kind of hacked save file are you got going on around here? Well, the reason why we have that, Dale. Was that your name, Dale? I don't know, man. There's too many voices at this point. The reason why it's like that is because we had Eden's Blessing we picked up, I believe, in the chest, which gave us a Tears upgrade on yesterday's run. And it gives us an extra item on the next run we start. No, doesn't matter if we're playing as Eden, doesn't matter if we're playing as Isaac. It doesn't matter who we're playing as. I mean, we're always playing as Isaac, obviously, but you know what I mean. You know what I freaking mean. So, of course, the glowing hourglass, which happens to be blue, it will rewind time and take us out of the previous room and undo anything that's happened. So if we happen to take red heart damage, for example, on a run that, or on a floor that we needed to get a double deal, and when assuming that we have a full charge by the end of the room that we're in, we can actually use the glowing hourglass to undo all of that. It will undo the time as well spent in a room, but there are, it will not give you back consumables. It will unreroll stuff, but it will not give you back, I believe, consumables unless you're in the store and you paid money for the reroll. Man, I don't know. You know what? Give me that heart back. I was going to say, I don't know what's been going on with me getting hit by retaliatory shots, but that right there is a big-time play because that allows us to maintain that soul heart. And this time around, we know that we're going to be able to undo that damage. So thank you very much, Glowing Hourglass. Glowing Hourglass can be quite good. You used to be able to break the game if you wanted to exploit your donation machine. I believe this has been patched though. But supposedly, I mean, you used to be able to use the donation trick where you would donate a bunch of money and then use the Glowing Hourglass and then just undo the money that you put in and then just redo it. But the donation machine stayed the same. I don't think you can do that anymore. Really? Really? The secret room is not there? Wow, that's shocking. That is like 100%. That would have been 100% wall, but now I got to rethink that room. That's now gone down to like a 90% wall there, the secret room. That's really surprising. All right, here we go, Libra. So as you see here, Libra dropped our damage. I wonder if I can I undo Libra? I cannot. Had I used it in the room just after picking up Libra, I think it may have been able to. But anyway, yeah. So Libra is going to balance all of our stats for the rest of the run. So any huge damage ups that we get is going to get converted to all stats. Same thing goes for movement speed, range, shot speed, et cetera, tears rate. I'm actually going to use the chariot card here only because I wanted to not take any more damage in there. Getting Guppy's collar on floor one is going to be amazing for us, of course. So now, what Libra does, Libra makes other items better. So if we were, for example, if we were to get, like, say, Speedball or Roid Rage, something like that here, off of Ragman. Libra is going to convert it. Instead of it just being like a huge movement speed up and a shot speed up, instead, it's going to turn that into an all stats up, including damage and possibly tiers. And that's what we're talking about when I say Libra just makes items better. So we get a shot speed up here as long with a range up. As you see here, it's going to convert to an all stats up. That's all thanks to Libra. We'll head on down. What a start. And thank you, everyone, for the World War II stories. I've been really enjoying watching the replies from everybody. So you see right there, we did not get the HP back that we spent to get into the curse room. So a little bit sad face on that. But we only spent half of a soul heart anyway, so it's not that big of a deal. But I've been really enjoying reading all the replies. People were talking about their grandparents, serving in the war for various sides, too. A lot of diverse cast. In the mosh pit, we had people who said that their family members fought for, the Axis. Lots of allies, grandparents and veterans in there. I mean, it's really, really cool to see just the diverse cast of characters that we have in the mosh pit. And I just love hearing about it. I love reading about it. So thank you very much for sharing your family stories on that. So here's Speedball, and as you're going to see here, it's going to turn into a fairly significant stats up because it is such a volatile... It is such a volatile speed upgrade and shot speed upgrade. It's a double stat up, which Libra takes, and then it basically gives you a double all stats up. You really want stuff like that. You want Roid Rage, which is a fantastic ability, or it's a fantastic pass to pick up in conjunction with Libra because of how many more stats you get from it. Obviously Magic Mush would be huge as well. We haven't seen Magic Mush in a bit. We need to see our favorite mushroom item in the game in a little bit. Super Secret Room is guaranteed to be right there. And we'll just go ahead and hold off on that for now. Let's go see what we got. Got ourselves a Dingle. And speaking of Dingle, later on today, at the 3 o'clock hour after Pokemon, you will see our first of the 2020 edition reroll. The first of the 2020 edition update for tier lists. So this time around, I redid the boss one, which includes the mini bosses this time, and I decided to change what I was actually rating them on as well. Instead of like annoyance factor, wow, our second syringe in two floors. That's pretty awesome. And, Azer Raid, sure, we'll take it just to lock in the deal with the devil, but I probably won't keep it. Because we already have a Guppy item, we should, and a full charge on the Glowing Hourglass, we should at least we've already been in the Curse Room. Let's slow our roll here. Let's check out to see what we have in the store, and this will determine whether or not we need to tap the Temperance Machine inside the Super Secret Room. I am going to go for Blanket here. Blanket is very, very good. Before we tap, let's see if we can get Petrified Poop or something. That would be nice. That would be ideal. Or just get a penny here. That would be fine, too. All right. Okay, so we're going to go for Blanket. The Blanket's going to give us the Holy Mantle effect, but only if we are fighting inside of the boss room. If we're not fighting the boss room, then we don't get the Holy Mantle effect, and that's okay. That's no problem. So we got the deal with the devil precedent. We've got a great passive item here, the blanket, and we'll head on down. As I talked about on Twitter yesterday, it's a funny game. As I talked about on Twitter yesterday, I was actually able to get my first night's sleep with the CPAP mask staying on my face for the entire duration of me being in bed, which is the first. That's the first time. It's pretty amazing considering that like I was pretty anxious last night when I went to bed, just because I was so tired. But like I was like, man, I just it's hard to not focus on the mask on your face at all times, you know, especially when you're not used to it. And I've seen some varying opinions of people, not opinions, but varying reports of people. Some people said that it took them months to get used to the mask. Other people said it only took a couple of days. You know, I think that the tolerance there is going to vary a lot. Cammy's head. Now, Tammy's head isn't quite worth doing this for the four keys. Wow, yeah. No, thank you. So you see there, we get the consumables back from that, and we don't get Tammy's head. I mean, I would take Tammy's head if we had a better tier effect, obviously. If we get Death's Touch on this floor, then yeah, sure, we'll go back and get Tammy's head. Same thing goes for Brimstone. But I like having the ability to undo damage to us. The Dagaz rune. Super Seek rune might be here. That's a 50-50 shot in that. We get Fast Bombs. Fast Bombs is going to give us 5 bombs, and I'm fine with that. You know what? Oh, wait, no, we don't have full charge. Never mind. I was gonna take the hit, go across the spikes to see if that chest is worth it, and then if it's not, we can just simply undo it with the glowing hourglass. We might as well go do it. That's the nice thing. Oh, the regular secret room's right here, by the way. That's the nice thing about the glowing hourglass is that it does have such a low cooldown. You can really undo a lot of damage with really no cost to you. I don't want to take the damage here, but I definitely want the dime. There we go. Yeah, that worked out. Worked out pretty good. Worked out pretty good. So I was surprised. I slept for about, I think, 7 hours last night, which is a good sign. I mean, I'm staying asleep later and later, which is good. But I still have the really weird weak feeling in my lungs. And I guess somebody pointed out it may not be your lungs that feel weak, it's actually your diaphragm, because you're actually having to work a little bit more than you used to. That, and of course, I'm so out of shape that like my I'm not gonna lose a soul heart for that. Let's try that again. You know, being out of shape, of course, my ab muscles, let's just say that my ab muscles are not the strongest muscle in my body right now. I can tell you that right now. I'm getting a little doughy around there. But I think that the assessment that it could be my diaphragm that's also kind of weak right now is a good one. So thank you very much for pointing that kind of stuff out. I mean, it's stuff that I wouldn't normally even assume. You know, but then again, I'm just a normal person. I'm not some kind of doctor or some kind of medical rocket science. That's right, medical rocket science. Not scientist, but science. Get the Locus of Death here, which is going to give us an attack spider or attack fly every time we walk into a room. It deals a decent amount of damage, but nothing to write home about. But definitely don't miss the updated boss tier list coming out later today at the 3 o'clock hour, about 3 hours after this video releases. And if you want to see more of those, make sure you're dropping a like over there. Experimental Treatment is an exclusive all stats down, but I'm only taking this because it's going to give a spun, which is a huge all stats up because of Libra. Yeah, so we gain a massive amount of damage there, despite us losing a little bit of tears. Okay, massive is a little bit of an exaggeration. It's not a massive amount of damage. 0.75 still is a very good amount of damage to gain via Libra. That's what we're looking for here. So I'm not going to use the Dagaz rune to purge the Curse of Darkness. I don't really care about the Curse of Darkness. The only time Curse of Darkness is annoying is either if you're in the womb or if you're in the burning basement, which we are not. The reason why I went for this one bomb here is because it doesn't cost us anything, and blowing up those mushrooms could potentially give us magic mush. So in my opinion, it's worth it just to check. But yeah, this is the second day in a row where I've had a really uneasy, it's almost like a nauseous feeling in a way in my stomach, but also like it's pertaining to like my breathing. Like it feels labored a little bit sometimes. Like I'm unable to catch up catching my breath. And I know that people are like, oh, that's a, you know, it's a pretty serious issue. It's only come up in the last 2 days. And it was because of me. I think it's because of the way that I have.
The moon.
Huh. I thought we were next to the. I guess that's the super secret room that we're next to. I think it's because of the way that I tightened the mask a little bit. It's made a little bit a better seal, so there's no more leaking with the air and stuff around my beard and nose and stuff. So I don't know if that's the true cause of it, but we'll see. If it's anything serious, of course, I'm coincidentally seeing a cardiologist for the first time in my entire life on Monday or Tuesday. It's early next week, so I'll keep everyone apprised of that. 9 volt. Let me be honest, 9 volt doesn't really tickle my fancy all that much here with the glowing hourglass. I mean, it assures that we get a use out of the glowing hourglass every single room, which is good. We can undo any damage that we inflict on ourselves, or is inflicted upon us. But it's my only hangup is that it's a premium item. It's a premium item that we could possibly get something better for to go with Libra. You know what I mean? Like, we don't need something that recharges the glowing hourglass that high or that fast. So I'm gonna pass on 9 volt for now. Just because I don't want to see it. I'm gonna pass on Diplopia just because I also am not okay. Well. Well then. And that's the beauty of the glowing hourglass, everyone, because we got Diplopia, and guess what's coming up next? Steam Seru. Now, all we gotta do is go make the 7 cents, and we have won the run. Now, the glowing hourglass shenanigans is just so dang good, man. You gotta love it. It's really an underrated item for what it can do and what it can undo, am I right? Okay, we got our nickel. We don't need any more money after this. So we're going to have double Steam sale, which gives us all items in the store for free forever for the rest of this run, which is pretty good, not going to lie. So we don't need money anymore. Yeah, you know, we'll take that. That's fine. I mean, I'll take a ladder, too. I'm not a huge fan. And I'll take Mom's coin purse in case we do happen to see, you know, PH Dizzle. Would be cool. We didn't, but at least we can take Ventricle Razor. Lover's Card. Don't really care about that. We go with the Ventricle Razor, the Glowing Hourglass. I think because the Glowing Hourglass got us to this point, I think it'd be an injustice to pass it up. If it wasn't for the glowing hourglass, we would not have been able to know that we've got double Steam Sale coming our way. So now all we need is restock, and we are happy. Our Degas room back. Oh, yeah. So we gotta see what's inside the super secret room. Was it worth the bomb? No.
Sinvicta, what are you doing leaving all that money behind, you nerd? You still have a donation machine, and possibly money equals power.
Well, Thrall, I mean, we're going to probably get more money, and we know it. Take it out of our pockets and show it and throw it like this way, that away. But I'm not worried about it at the expense of 2 bombs. That's the downside of the ladder right there, by the way. The ladder just showing up whenever you're not trying to use it. You're trying to exercise your right to use the entire room that you're in. I think there might be some surprises on the tier list video for you all. And, oh, by the way, I keep forgetting to mention the differences between the last boss tier list and the one that I made today. This time around, instead of me taking a completely arbitrary, opinionated piece about the boss tier, I've taken a different route, which I'll talk about in a moment. So for this boss tier, tier list around this time around, I don't know why I said it like that. Instead of me saying like, oh, these are the bosses I like, these are the bosses I don't like, this is why we can't have fun. Instead, it's a little bit more analytical, and it is the likelihood, it's a tier list of the difficulty of fighting the bosses without taking damage. So in other words, the bosses at the very top of the list are almost impossible to do for me. I'm talking about just specifically for me when I play the game, to not take damage. You know, so I'll go ahead and spoil one of them. Delirium is at the very top. Obviously, he's extremely hard. Even though he's a terribly designed boss and buggy boss and everyone hates him, there's no denying that it's almost impossible to pull a no-hit on him. So it's basically like the no-hit boss tier. I'll come up with a catchy name for it before the video goes out tomorrow. Today, technically, for you all. You know, the likelihood of no-hitting the bosses. Which bosses are the easiest to no-hit? No, let's see. Let's see if we can develop a title on our own here while we're flying through this run. You saw, by the way, the nice amount of all stats that we got from Mom's Underwear. Nah, not a fan of Epic Fetus. It's too, just not a fan. Yeah, we should come up with a catchy title for that tier list, the 2020 update. Hardest bosses to no hit tier list. Is that too convoluted? Maybe I should keep it simple. Just hardest bosses to not take damage from. Silver dollar means that we get stores inside of the womb, which is actually really good. Let's try that again, game. No way we should have gotten trapped down there. That was a foolish decision. That cost me a soul heart. No, thank you. I'm going to take Tammy's head because the likelihood of us finding Brimstone is very, very high, especially if we get restocked because of the double steam sale. And if not Brimstone, then the likelihood of us getting like Tech Zero or Death's Touch is very, very high. That's assuming we get restock and Chaos. If we get restock, we will get Chaos and we will get the rest of the item because it's impossible for us not to get every item in the game pretty much. So if we get restock, that's all we need. Pandora's Box, gonna give us HP here. Got the Bibble, Ace of Clubs, which we don't care about. Come on, restock. That's all we're looking for. Get the Potato Peeler, which I can't use, unfortunately. I'll take Jumper Cables. Jar of Flies is real good. We are almost full on HP now. We got a moon card. Come on, restock. More options. Or there's options, I should say. It's going to give us a double boss item drop for the rest of the run. Unfortunately, we only have one more of those. Actually, two more of those. I take that back. Come on, restock. Get Blank Ukadu. Hey, now we can use Converter and then use Potato Peeler. There we go. Got ourselves a nice little all stats up. You know, the temptation is there for us to use Blank Card, but I'm not going to. Apparently, we picked up the compass. Get another moon card. Might be getting a little too ambitious here. But I felt the need to do that because we have Libra. Although, with this setup now, I'm more inclined to take the Glowing Hourglass, just in case we get dealt a whole lot of damage. But we have a level 4 cube of meat, also known as Super Meat Boy. And now, we also have a whole lot of extra stats that we got, thanks to the Soul Converter. What the Soul Converter is it will take 3 of your Soul Hearts and turn into a Red Heart container, and then we use, instead of that, instead of us holding on to that, We used the potato peeler to give us a damage up and a cube of meat every time we used it. Shame that we haven't found BFF yet. But we still have a couple more floors yet left with the stores, thanks to the silver dollar. And I think Roid Rage is better for Libra. And it is. And we'll head on down with 10 damage. All right. On the dank Depsu. Now again, I stress that if we didn't use all of our HP for that, for the shenaniganery of the potato peeler, then I would have stuck with Tammy's head. But I think it was worth it for us to get a level 4 cube of meat and also for the stat ups that we got. Actually, a pretty dangerous room here. If this super greed head hits us, we will die. But Super Meat Boy just said, hoof to that. Let me just toss you onto these spikes real quick there, Pimpin'. But Super Meat Boy said, hoof to that. Let me just toss you on these spikes real quick here, Pimpin'. Yeah, we'll take Common Cold. Common Cold's going to give us a poison shot every now and then. Of course, what we're really looking forward and we're hyper-focused on getting is going to be getting to the store, hoping that there's not a greed fight in there, which we know there's not because we've already fought Wrath. And then them just finding restock. That's all we got to do. Necesito uno restocko. Okay. One of the red monstros just yeeted himself. Very kind of him. This is it's a pretty horrible room. We did not get the self-eating monstro this time. It's a champion monstro, so we don't want to get hit by any of them. Easier said than done, because like there's freaking four of them, but you know, what can you do? That is why we took the glowing hourglass. I will take stopwatch. I'm not going to take Sharp Plug because I sometimes accidentally double tap the spacebar item, and I don't want to do that to myself. I also do not want modem lag because it's one of the worst items in the game. Brack, Candle, Bundadu. Hello. World. Black Candle, good to see you. We love you, we missed you. It'd be real sad if we don't get restock. But we still have two stores to go, so Humbling Bundadu is pretty much worthless, but it's worthless only because, like, we don't need money. We get Hive Mind. The Sun card. We also got Beelzebub. Very nice indeed. What a run, man. What a run. Beelzebub's going to give us flying. The reason why we got Beelzebub is because we've gotten three fly items. The other flight items that we've gotten are Wandering Fly or Lost Fly, Hivebind, and what was our third bug item? Hivebind, Lost Fly. I'm losing my mind. We got a third Beelzebub item, I just don't remember which one. That's bothering me now. Okay, Hive Mind. Lost Fly. I don't know. I'm clearly forgetting one, and I'm driving you guys and gals crazy just trying to remember it, but, you know. I apologize. Whoa, they're still alive in there, huh? Not common cold. I don't think Guppy's collar counts as one. Oh, you know what? It's Jar of Flies. We touched Jar of Flies. That's right. That's right. I remember. Calm yourselves. Drop the torches and pitchforks. I remembered. It's Jar of Flies. Good on you, Mosh Pit. We get Void and Rotten Baby. I'm going to go Rotten Baby here. You would think that I would go Void, but I'm not going to. Now, I will admit, it is a little bit of a... What am I doing? I've got flying. It is a little bit of a bold move for us to take the negative here. Get our second Guppy item for free. And of course, Guppy's head plus Hive Mind is a ton of damage. But it doesn't undo damage. Doesn't undo damage like the Glowing Hourglass does. Yeah, it's a little bit of a bold move for us to take the negative here. But I have faith because of these two extra shops that we're getting, and because we're probably going to get Guppy. I hope. Now, if we don't get Guppy, then fighting the lamb is going to be a little bit iffy. But our damage plus our flies is very, very, very high. Without our flies, our damage is still good. It's not like it's not barn burning. Like, oh, we're just gonna one shot everything good. But it's like two shottable good. And honestly, shout out to Libra. Shout out to Libra for making the big time plays. But I still think the MVP goes to the Glowing Hourglass. Faux show. Oh, show. So, of course, we get a greed fight in our extra shop here. No surprising anybody. I should say not surprising anybody. You're wondering where that second charge came from there. That was from the jumper cables that we got. Every 15 enemies that we kill, we will get one charge on our space bar item. And because our space bar item only has one charge, then every time it procs, we get a full charge. Ain't that neat? Plenty of bombs here. Should check for magic mush. A little bit too close for comfort there, I'm not gonna lie. We should have probably gotten hit by that bad gas. So you might be asking yourselves, Nicta, how come you don't take pills if you have Libra? It is true, taking pills while having Libra, it does negate a fair bit amount of the negative stats that you could give yourself. But I don't think that matters. And what I mean by that is I don't think it matters in the grand scheme of things. Because the stat ups that you get from pills are really negligible. So, you know, if you happen to get positive pills, sure. Sure, it's a great thing to get. But to me personally, it's not worth prioritizing. Oh boy, we get store credit. So there's no mini boss, which means that probably gonna get trolled again by the game and give us another greed fight in our last store. I'm going to take the Locus of Conquest because we no longer need the silver dollar, since this is the last time the silver dollar will ever be useful to us. And we say useful in a very loose way because it hasn't been useful to us because we got a greed fight in our first one. But the Locus of Conquest will give us a white locust or a couple of white flies every single time we go into a new room. And again, as you can imagine, with the combined damage of all of our flies plus Hive Mind, that can produce a significant amount of extra damage as soon as we walk into the room for free, every single room. So that is why the Locust Conquest is awesome here in conjunction with Hive Mind. Something I tell everybody, new Isaac players and veterans alike, don't be afraid to skip. Skip rooms. Just skip rooms. Who's gonna try to tell you that you're not allowed to skip rooms? Not me. I think you are a fool if you don't skip rooms that you don't feel like doing. Amazingly, we did not get a greed fight in here, so thank you very much for that, game. Emperor card, I love it. There she blows. Here we go. Oh, man. Restock. You knew it was just only a matter of time. It was only a matter of time. Spider mod guy cheering out of his gourd right now. I don't even know what that means. And because we have restock now, all that means is that we just need chaos. Chaos is it. So until we step on chaos, you're safe. You are 100% safe to stand on top of the item spawn until you get chaos. Then you're not. The reason why you're not after you get chaos is because you could inadvertently step on top of missing no, and you don't want to do that. Mama Omega. Tarot cloth. BFFs, there we go. Red Candidate. Champion belt, you gotta love it. Compost, how you doing? Broken watch, pretty bad. Mom's purse, whatever. Mystery gift, sure. Broken modem's awful, but it's not going to matter for us in the grand scheme of things. There it is, chaos. And look at that, we get chaos, we get the trinket smelter after getting mom's box, which is huge, 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 McHuge face. Because now we can smelt a whole bunch of amazing trinkets, which is going to help us out in a big way. There it is, the cantrip trinket and the curved horn. And then we're going to smelt them. And then we're going to hold on to mom's box here. There's Guppy. Dude, we just destroyed this run. And it goes back to the glowing hourglass. Glowing hourglass 100% gets credit for this. Because we would not have been able to do that if we didn't know that Diplopia and Steam Sale was coming. So now what we're looking for is Crack Crown. There we go. Trickle Charge is also going to be pretty nice. I think that's pretty much all we care about. So let's get Crack Crown, Trickle Charge. We need a full charge here. And then we can compost everything off the ground just so we don't have to worry about them. Yep. Do that. And we might as well go for the Bloody Crown and Locus of Conquest again, because, I mean, you know, it's a great combo. What else do we want? We want Pay to Win? Pay to Win, how you doing? Lucky Rock, how you doing? Yeah, we'll take that. Sure. I mean, Counterfeit Penny and, you know, we got to go for Baby Bender here. And we'll also take, we'll take that. We'll take these two. Counterfeit Penny and Black Feather. Now remember, our stats are going to change immensely as soon as we pick up Mom's Box. Watch this. Yeah, it's real good. It's real, real good. Where'd Trinket Smelter go? Get over here. Take that. We're going to take the Golden Horseshoe as well as the Locus of Pestilence to give us, again, more flies. And we might as well take Swallow Penny. Not that it's really going to matter. And, yeah, absolutely, give me Fishtail because we're Guppy. You're about to see a really powerful run, and I mean super mega-powered run. But you know what? Give me the trinkets. Actually, no, we can't take it because we've got compost. There we go. Just get all that crap off the ground. As you see here, it doesn't matter which slot we have Mom's Box in. We only lose the stats if we get rid of Mom's Box, I think. Yeah, once we switch off, it's gone. So we have to make sure that once we leave here, we have to have Mom's Box as our primary spacebar item. Otherwise, we don't get the stats. We have to drop it somehow. I don't really want Greed's Gullet, if I'm honest. Lump of Coal is fine. Okay, let's go here. We got that. We got Linger Bean. We got ourselves a pentagram. Got ourselves a prayer card. We got ourselves a dinner. We got ourselves a Mr. Me. Got ourselves a 1-Up. Shade, Sinvicta Robes, H Pizzle, Core of Babalizzle, Guppy's Pawizzle, Satanic Bibble. This is the good stuff right here. This is the kind of run that you just sit back and enjoy. You just got to be careful of missing no. That's all you got to do. If we can dodge the missing no, we can dodge the world. I don't even know what that means, but it sounds good. Now, if this were on the Twitch save file, I would simply just say, "Hey, let's stand until we get missing no or whatever." I don't want to get missing no, for the record. Sensor, Plan C, no thank you. There's the Halo. I'll take Curse of the Towers. Doesn't really matter. I mean, it is impossible for us to lose this run. Impossible. We are about to stomp this game into the dirt. Euthanasia, Brother Bobby, which is going to probably give us conjoined. I think we're one away from conjoined. Circle Protection. Hey, Compost, you mind helping us out here? There's no full charges. Why is there no full charges? Steven, okay, there's our full charge. Let's get some of that stuff off the ground. There we go. And then when we leave here, we can use Guppy's Paw. We can use Guppy's Paw to get rid of all of our Red Heart containers. I think it goes without saying that everyone will hate me if I take Mom's knife here, and I would also hate myself. No, 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 no. Hang on, hang on, hang on, hang on, hang on. Before we reroll these pedestals, because I don't want Mom's knife, get rid of that. Pick up Mom's box of trinkets. There we go. Okay, now we can reroll.
Dice shard.
Sad bombs. Get Pyro. That is not the explosion immunity Pyro, by the way. I actually don't want the virus because I think it's a stats down because of the movement speed down. Definitely do not want Cursed Eye, of course. I don't care if we have Black Candle or not. Mr. Mega, I will take Bob's Brain because of Sad Bombs. I thought that was... I fooled me. I thought that was an item. Halo Flies, Mom's Wig, sure. Book of Revelations, 8-inch Nails, now we're talking. Dad's Key, Scatter Bombs, I'm less than excited about. Ghost Pepper, more options. What's in the box? Butterbean. Looks like Dark Prince's Crown, I think. You guys need to chill out. You need to come back over here. You're cramping my style here. Okay, let's get rid of everything. Get glitter bombs. Let's see trolls. Bumbo, I guess. Succubus. Bomber Boy, yeah. It's gonna be pretty good with Bob's Brain, not gonna lie. Fat on Mushroom. Belly Button gives us 2 trinket slots, which we've already been over that. We don't need anymore. Head of the Keeper, yeah. Undefined. I'm not sure. Oh, it's Succubus that gave us the aura. I was like, why did we drop to 1? I remembered Succubus is around us. Okay, I think that's probably pretty good. We don't need to go full breakage here. Forget Me Now is actually quite hilarious. Well, there's Cursed Eye. I'm not taking Cursed Eye. And I accidentally took Cursed Eye anyway. I was trying to sidestep that. Cricket's Head's fine. Man, I wish I had the glowing hourglass to undo that. There's Death's Touch. Binky. All right. Then, yeah. All right. Well, we've got ourselves a quite the build here. I will say we did get an item room because now that we have the golden horseshoe, or the bloody crown, I should say, it's gonna give us an item room in the womb. Okay, I think we can re-roll this for something a little bit sweeter. Looking for something sweeter. We do not need tears. Just damage is fine. Sure. I guess we'll take Trinity Shield. Yeah, Key Bomb and Bum Friend are going to have quite the time on their hands here. Now we just have 126 range, no problem. So check out our Devil Deal from Stanley. I will take Seraphim, and yeah, we'll trade an HP for an HP. And we got a Yara Rune, and the bomb that came out of nowhere, apparently. All right. All credit for this goes to the glowing hourglass. 1,000%. I can't even tap fast enough. Stanley instantly died. I can't even tap fast enough for us to fire because our tears rate's so low. It's however how fast that I want to tap. That's it. I think what we'll do is we'll do a victory lap. I think we've earned it on this run. Solid Devil Deal right there. Thank you, Chaos. Double Yara Rune. You know what? I'm actually going to do that. Now you might be saying why. Why would you do that? Well, because double AWAS is going to save us a lot of time on the next run. And I really want to see how fast we can go. I want to see if we can break, if we can do an entire run in like 2 minutes. I wish that I had blank card for this, but I don't. So let's see if we can do an entire run on a victory lap in 2 minutes. Is it possible? I mean, yeah, it's possible if you have the shovel, which we don't, but we'll see. I'll skip some of the later levels. Yeah, get out of here. All right. After the break, here we go. On the move. Now I don't think. I'll show the seed after we're done with Blue Baby. I don't think that we should use our AWAS runes at the very beginning here. I think we should use it to get past probably the... Well, we can't use it to get past the depths, so probably the flooded caves. Unless if we get, like, an XL floor, then I'll use it there. We don't care about Devil Deals, obviously. It's just a waste of precious seconds here. Catacombs 1... A little bit of an annoying floor, but I think we can deal with it. I don't know how. Well, we're going to some way. Already at 30 seconds. I'll probably skip the next two floors. Yeah, let's cancel this one. Depths 1, again, pretty far away. Depths 2, there we go. We can't skip this one. The reason why we can't skip it is because, obviously, we need the Polaroid. Hey, I remember this room. Monstro's death animation takes so dang long. So this is the fastest victory lap without having the shovel or blank card Emperor. I'm not going to do boss rush because I think that's going to slow us down way too much. Again, I'm trying to get a sub 2 minute run here. Last assist takes a long time to die. Oh, a death never looked and felt so good. Please. All right, we got a minute and a half. Or no, I mean, we got 47 seconds. We're at a minute and a half almost. What's going on here? I should have just bombed my way through that room. 23 seconds. Yeah, we're not waiting for the mom hand. Gotta... No! I didn't want to go into the void! I didn't even see the void there! Oh man! I didn't even see the void there, man. You can't do that to me. I was wrestling with the idea of fighting old Hushy. Well, our 2 minute dream is over. Thanks to the void, of course. Thanks to Delirium. Thanks to the void. I think that we could have done it too. It would have been real close. I mean, it's a 2 minute Delirium kill, I guess, but. Well, almost Delirium kill. We can never find the jerk. Leave it to Delirium to ruin your fun. Come on, Stanley. We ain't got time for this. We already been over this in this run. I'm unreasonably upset about getting voided, though. Might as well take a little bit of extra stats here. But unfortunately, we went to the wrong half of the entire world. And Delirium is probably the one that's located at the very, 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 very far left. My guess. And we're going straight for him. So I guess if we can get like a sub 4 minute Delirium kill, sure. I don't know what's considered good for Delirium or not on a victory lap. But either way, this run's been awesome. So I hope you all enjoyed it. If you did, click the like button. It shows you the power of course it's not Delirium. It shows you the power of not only the glowing hourglass, but also Libra. Libra has a huge part to play in this run. But we would have never gotten to this point without having the glowing hourglass, and letting it give us the double steam sail into chaos roll that we so desperately wanted. And as was Sinvicta luck would have it, the last boss that we fight on this entire freaking map is going to be Delirium. Because that's just how it works. Excuse me. How is it possible there's anything left alive in this room? Yep, there we go. Last boss. Even when we thought that we had him nailed down, it's Delirium. Very good for you. We're very happy for you, Delirium. Thank you for watching, everyone. Like I said, let's keep that like streak goal going. 12,000 likes on the No Seas run is incredible. How much will a broken run featuring the blowing hourglass and the double steam sail get? Well, I don't know. Let's find out. Thank you again, everybody. Check out my Patreon. Check out joining the members of the Mosh Pit MVP. You can join the channel. If you want to support myself in other ways, support all the series. Thank you for the support of the Pokemon series and GeoGuessr as well. Keep an eye out for the tier list coming at you a little bit later on today. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody!